So far, at least 53 countries have joined the call for an international ceasefire so the world can band together to fight a common enemy, COVID-19. At a time where global cooperation has never been more urgent, countries are stepping up to show true international solidarity. But the U.S. empire has brazenly shown it will only weaponize the crisis, making disregard for life its official policy. Here at home, Americans anticipate the worst, left to suffer and die by their leaders in a corporate sacrifice zone. Rich politicians love to say that we're all in this together, but it's clear we are not. It's just those of us who were screwed by the corporate bailout and those abroad living under U.S. domination who are all truly in this together. One thing is for sure, there's no going back from this moment. This crisis exposes the true nature of our imperialist system. But that also means that together, we can turn our collective hopelessness into collective radicalization.